You might have already seen these complex elements. Subtitle timecode are time sequences that allow you to sync your subtitles with your video. While they often go unnoticed, subtitle timecode are yet decisive to match your video, speech and captions together. Especially if they are misaligned, they can create a real feeling of discomfort for your viewers, and so you really need to properly optimize them. One of the ways of doing timecode is to put them and edit them on an SRT file. Here I'm gonna show you how to quickly create, optimize, and also remove the timestamps from your SRT file. Here we go. To begin with, what do you do when you don't have the timecode of your video speech yet? One way to proceed is to create your timestamps manually by typing the time position of each of your subtitle sequences. Practically, what it means is to comply to a very specific subtitle format like SRT. SRT subtitles files are actually readable by every video platform on the market, and to craft one, you might need a text editor like Notepad or TextEdit on Mac and start your subtitle sequences in the way I'm gonna show you here. To encode your transcript in an SRT file, you need first to define the number of each of your subtitle sequences according to their occurrence order. You need then to define the beginning and the end of your subtitle sequences by adding 3-digit timestamps, an arrow, and 3 other digit timestamps. Finally, you need to add at the bottom the text sequences related to your timestamps. About that, you should cut your text in short intervals, about approximately 35 characters per subtitle. When you have done all of that, you still have to redo the process and check the synchronization until your subtitles are displayed in the right timing for your viewers. Now, you also might have already a SRT file. So in that case, let's see how you can optimize your timecode so that your video speech and caption can match perfectly. The important thing here is to be accurate in the timing and counting of your sequences. And this process can be made easier. You can rely, for example, on a sound spectrum to properly set the beginning of your subtitle sequence exactly when there's a sound frequency peak. Like that, subtitle software like decisive or subtitle edit provide you with such tool to edit your timecode more precisely. With that kind of tool, you can also know immediately when to cut the subtitle sequence for the sake of the viewer's understanding. Thus, when the frequency peak is lowered, that's when you should end the subtitle sequence. But you can also let it display 2 or 3 seconds more so that some viewers can catch up on their reading. So now, it can also happen that you want to remove the timecode from your SRT file, for example, to get only the transcript of your video. And to do that, what you need to do is to go on the blog post below the video about how to create, optimize, remove subtitle timecode on checksub.com. To go on the section about how to remove the timecode, copy paste this formula, then go on a software like Notepad++, which can help you code your files, go on search, replace, paste the formula, add this symbol. Be sure to click on match case and regular expression. Also, put the cursor on the very top of your file and then click on replace all. As you can see here, you only have the transcript with the number. You can also erase the number entirely like that. Oh, my bad. And then get the full transcript of your video. Finally, I couldn't end this video without showing you a solution at Checksub, which can help you do timecode even faster than our solution on the market. So Checksub actually provides you with an interface that helps you do synchronization very easily. And here I'm gonna do a little demo about this solution to show you how it works. So to use ShakeSub, you need to go on myshakesub.com, upload a new project and your video, choose between automatic and professional, and when the process is done, you get to this interface. You click on language and you access the ShakeSub editor, subtitle editor. So as you can see here, the transcription is done quite accurately. The only thing that you need to do is to manage the time sequences to match them with the speech. So as you can see, ShakeSub interface is quite useful for that. So you can change it like here. And the thing is, when you're done with that, just have to click on exportation, SRT, and then get the transcript in the SRT format. And so also the time codes, the accurate time codes on the SRT file here. As you can see, it's as simple as that. So now that you have all the tools on your hands to do and manage your timecode effectively on your SRT file, we'll let you test it all out. And if you have any question or help, feel free to contact us.